So read the question. Match the columns in the following table and explain the daily. Okay. So first one is your farsightness, plus myopia and nearsightness. Okay. Column 2, if you read here, you will get your nearby object can be seen clearly. Then next one is your given far away object can be seen clearly. And problem of old age. So column 3 is given about the lenses, that bifocal lens, concave lens, convex lens. Very simple. So if you see here, we are getting it farsightedness means far away can see clearly. Okay, then it's corrected by which lens, concave or convex? Who tell me? This farsightedness is corrected by which? Yes, Soham.
Convex lens.
It is a convex lens. So like this, we are getting this first column completed. Then press myopia. Will tell me, Jay? Jay?
Sir, problems of old age.
Problems of old age. So here we are getting this answer, and it is corrected by bifocal lens. Okay, and now last remain easily you can understand, that is the harshyakta, nearsightedness.
Nearby object can be seen clearly.
Nearby object can be seen clearly and concave lens is using it. Very good. So now, see the question. Question is given there. Match the columns in the following table and explain them. We have to not just only to match this column. We have to explain it also. Okay, about the farsightedness, we can write this effect known as the hypermetropia. And it is an eye effect. Eye defect is there in which the person is unable to see. Which things are closer to his eyes. But he can see, or she can see, which objects are far away from them. Okay. And then what's the reason for it? That is a reduction in the curvature, center of curvature of the lens. And next one is a decrease in the size of eyeball. Okay. Since we are correcting by the convex lens. Now second, when we are going to speak about a nearsightedness, this is an eye defect. We know that this happens. Okay. And in this eye defect, what happens? That person can see clearly nearby objects, but he or she is unable to see which are their far away objects. Okay, and what's the reason behind it? This nearsightedness also called as the myopia. Okay, and this is the reason behind it. Increase in the curvature of lens and increase in the length of eyeball. In first farsightedness, what happened there? Length is increases or it's become a pattern that you have to decide and write it. Okay. About the presbyopia, if you speak about the presbyopia, this happened due to the age factor. Very important thing there. This is a happened due to the age factor, and due to the age factor, what happened? The accommodation power of eyes is going on decreases. Okay. And we know that this is corrected by the bifocal lens. Got it, everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now we are going to draw a figure explaining various terms related to lens. Now here, which are the terms related to lens? You have to come. Already it's mentioned here. So these are terms here related to the lens, which is that center of curvature, then radius of curvature, next one optical center, principal focus, focal length. These are the concepts related to the lens. Okay, getting it? Yes or no? And this you have to write, yes, with the help of diagram. Okay, you have to write this with the help of diagram. Its definition also you have to write in it. Okay, now question number 3 we are going to see here. What is given in the question number 3? So if you see in the question number 3, at which position will you keep an object in front of a convex lens so as to get a real image of the same size as the object and draw a figure? Now this is a question for given us. So where it's we are getting that, if you see if it's possible in our textbook only, I'm going to show you, otherwise I'll draw it. Real image, see there in front of you. Are you getting it? This is a real image. So in this, you can see here an object will be placed beyond the point 2F1 and incident rate BC, starting from B and going parallel to the principal axis. This you will see. So we are getting here as a this one also you can write. Okay, getting it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, are you getting what I am speaking here? समजतंय काय चाललंय ते?
यस सर.
ओके, सो नाव दिस फिगर इट्स व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज केप्ट ऍट द सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर ट्वाइस एफ वन. सी देअर व्हेअर ऑब्जेक्ट इज केप्ट ऍट द सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर ट्वाइस एफ वन ऑफ अ कॉन्वेक्स लेन्स विल गेट द रियल इमेज ऑफ द सेम साइज ऍज द ऑब्जेक्ट. जस्ट यू हॅव टू ड्रॉ दिस फिगर अँड व्हेअर यू हॅव टू कीप दॅट ओनली यू हॅव टू राईट. ओके, again I am repeating that sentence. When you listen to this video you will get it. When an object is placed at the center of curvature 2f1 of a convex lens, means here we have to keep this 2f1, okay, of a convex lens, we will get a real image of the same size as the object. Means here this is actually not a we are getting there smaller, but when we are going to keep this at this 2f1, where we have to keep this here is your 2f1, so you will get their same size of image will be not that small, and this you will get here, that is a bigger or same size of it. Okay, understood everyone? Yes or no? Instead of drawing this, don't draw like this, you have to draw here. Okay, and this we have to not explain here figure, just we have to draw it. Now we'll see the next question. Question number 4, give scientific reasons. What is the first one? Simple microscope is used for watch rivers. So what is the reason? Who will tell me? Raise your hands. Okay, one only student want to tell. Yes, Harsh, you can.
So as we know that watches are very small, watches are small in size, and their parts are also small in size, and if there is any defect in the watch, the repairer have to repair it. The simple microscope has a very good magnifying power from which it is used for which it is used for magnifying the any small object. So the watch repairers use the simple microscope to magnify the parts of the watches where the defect is, and it is useful and helpful for the repairers to understand what is the defect in the watch and to repair it carefully.
Very nice, your answer by Harsh. So what is their simple microscope? When we are going to speak, it has their convex lens, okay, and which is having the ability to produce image more than its original 20 times we can produce their image through this. Okay, so this having the their magnifying power is the higher, so due to that reason this simple microscope we can use, because already if you see here, those watch parts are they are very tiny parts, so these tiny parts we can't see by our naked eyes, and by through this glass or through this convex lens we can observe it easily, we will get that clear image. So due to that reason we are have to use, means suppose that watch repairers are using their simple microscope. Samastha, yes or no?
Yes, yes sir.
Okay, or there is a need to speak in Marathi?
No sir. No sir.
Okay, so now second question, one can sense colors only in bright light. So about this bright light, if you see those have read this textbook properly, they will get this answer here. Okay, the cells present on the retina, that is there are two types of cells are present That is the first one cell is there, rod-like cells, and second one there, cone-like cells are there. And rod-like cells gives respond to the intensity of light and give the information about brightness or dimness. Okay. So what is your question? One can sense colors only in bright light. So why this happen? Because if those colors are getting in the bright light, that directly reaching to our eye lens. And when it's reaching to our eye lens, then I reach on the retina. There is a two types of cells are present. One is the rod-like and second one there, cone-like cells. And conical cells only respond in the presence of light only. It's not possible. Without light, it can show you which color is present there. Okay. So its answer will write here like this. 1 minute. So write down the answer like this here. You a very simple answer. So the cells present on the retina and the responsible for color vision are known as the cone cells. These cells become active only under bright light and remain inactive under dark. Thus we are able or sense only in bright light. Why we can see that colors? Because these conical cells are active in bright light only, not in the dark. Okay. Now next question we have to see, that is the third one. We can clearly see an object kept at distance less than 25 centimeter from the eye. So what is the reason behind it? Can you tell me? Anybody? Nobody there? Okay. So, if you see here, if the object is kept less than 25 centimeter from the eye, that time our ciliary muscles get their stress. Okay, what is your question? First, understand. We cannot see clearly see an object kept at a distance less than 25 centimeter from the eye. That's the main reason that because this is our near point of the our eye, that is a 25 centimeter. Okay, when an object is kept near to that less than 25 centimeter, that time our eyes have to their eye lenses or that cells become distressed. And due to that reason, it's not possible to see that object clearly. So here a reason you can write like this: we cannot clearly see an object kept at a distance less than 25 centimeter from the eye because this is ciliary muscles of our eyes are unable to contract beyond their certain limit. If the object it's kept less than 25 centimeter from the eye, then the object appears blurred because light rays coming from the object meet behind the retina. When we are keeping this object less than 25 centimeter, then that image is obtained behind the retina, not on the retina. Okay, understood? Yes or no? Samasthe?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Adson. Okay. So now here, given their question for you, explain the working of an astronomical telescope using refraction of light. Now astronomical, it is given or not, that we are going to see. Yes, it's given in front of you, this here, refracting telescope. Okay, this refracting telescope is used by these astronomers. Okay, and here what's given there, you can see the astronomical telescopes consist like it's a regular telescope having their two lenses, that is one is their objective lens and second one is their eyepiece. Okay. Objective lens is having their higher focal length or larger focal length and diameter to accommodate maximum amount of light coming from the far away. Means from which is their distance, which is the planet or whatever thing we are going to keep or we have to observe. So this objective lens can collect their more light from that object. Okay. And parallel beam of rays from an astronomical object is made to fall on the objective lens of the telescope. It forms a real image. It is inverted and diminished image at here. If you see, this is your F1. Where is it? Your this FE. Okay. Then it forms the real inverted and diminished image at this point FE of the object, and the eyepiece is so adjusted that the AB, here you see, If you see this here, we are getting the image first, this pointer, not here directly, we are getting here final image. And then, this we can write, we are getting here image that I am going to give here name, okay. Suppose this is your, at this place, we are going to give their name A dash here B dash, okay. So first we will get your image and then afterwards it will be focused through the this eye lens or eyepiece and then we will get our your final image. Okay, getting it shown? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This only, yes, figure, sir. This only figure, just you have to do little changes you can use for your answer. Okay. Now we have to see the next question. That is the question number 6. It's a very simple question. You can write it easily. Write the distinction between farsightedness and nearsightedness. So already above only here we have seen these all things. So your first definition of the farsightedness, you can write that person can see the object which is there far away from his eyes, but he can't see those objects are near to his eyes. Okay, or unable to see clearly those objects are near to eyes. And which lens are used there for the correcting it? Convex lens. Like this, we can write its answer. Okay. And maximum points, you can write, we have to read it. Minimum 4 points, you have to write in it. How many points? 4 points. So, first point, you can write a definition. Second point, what is the reasons? Third point, you can draw the figure. And fourth point, which lens is used for the correcting that defect? Nearsightedness, we know that nearsightedness is also the same thing. It's here that person can see clearly objects which are closer to eyes and those are far away from that, that person unable to recognize that object or whatever their things are present. Then what is the reason behind it? The it's to increase in the lens or curvature of the eye lens and the increase in the length of eyeball. What is the reason for the far nearsightedness and for farsightedness you could speak. So there is a decrease in the curvature of eye lens or decrease in length of eyeball. Now, second one about the concave lens and convex lens, you're right. So we should know the concave lens is the diverging lens and concave lens is the, convex lens is the converging lens. Remember this first difference between it. And what happened in concave lens, you divert the light rays, whatever there from the lens. And in the about convex lens, it is there converged. Okay. The second point, we have learned already, it is a thin at the center and one at the edge. Okay. About the convex lens, it is a thin at the edge and one at the corners or edges. Okay. And here, this concave lens is used to always diminish and virtual image. It is observed to it, that is a diminished and virtual image. And about it, you can see this convex image is formed real as well as virtual image. Got it? Yes or no? And fourth one point is there, it has a virtual focus for the concave lens and for the convex lens, it has the real focus. Are you getting it, Shons? What's going on? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Any problem here after the question number 6?
No, sir.
Nobody's having problem? Okay. So now we are going to see the next part, that is what is the function of iris and muscles connected to the lens in human eye. So just here only you'll get your answer. Already we have seen that topic. What is the function of iris? Okay. So you can read it very well, you'll get that. The function of iris is there. The iris is a muscular part or diaphragm that controls the size of pupil. What is its function is there? It's control the pupil. For why? Because according to the light rays falling on it, it will be contract or it will be expand. So like this, we can see here, this is the function of iris. Okay. And you can see here, it's control the amount of light entering the eye and it is also given colors to the eye. What is there? Due to the disease, we can see which color is there. So about iris, when you write, light enters the eye through, means maximum amount of light is reflected inside the eye at the outer surface of the cornea, and there is a dark place screen behind the cornea, and this is called iris. You can write a definition, and the colors of the iris is different for different person. You can write light is answer also. And next one, their function of ciliary muscles. What is the ciliary muscles? Ciliary muscles, they are very important. The eye lens is held in the position by the ciliary muscles. These ciliary muscles are holding to the, this our eye lens. Okay. And if you see here, the focal length of our eye lens is adjusted by these ciliary muscles only. So like this, your this question number 7 answer. Now we are going to see. Do you want repetition of this answer? Yes or no, students? If you understood the problem, then you'll get the solution. But what happened? In hurry, we make worry, and due to that reason, we are not reading it carefully, and we are feeling that a problem is tough. Actually, problem is not tough, remember. Problem is not tough, just we are not looking towards it very sincerely. We think that it's a problem, then leave it. So if you read the problem, immediately you are getting some ideas. Through that ideas, we can write the answer. Now here you can see. Doctor has prescribed a lens having power plus 1.5D means 1.5 diopter. What would be the focal length of the lens? What is the type of the lens, and what must be the defect of vision? Some students have written like this answer in test as it is. They don't know the steps and procedure. They directly written like this answer. Actually, it's not correct way. So now here again, I'm reading that problem. See here, doctor has prescribed a lens having power. So here we are getting the power of lens. Okay, we are getting here power of lens. So we are getting here power of lens, that is a P is equal to, what is given in the P? If you see, we are getting here plus 1.5. Because sometimes their number is negative, so its mention sign is also there, 1.5 diopter. Okay, there. What we have to find here? Focal length. What we have to find? Focal length of it. And next thing, which type of lens we have to use? And what is the defect of that person? So now here, very easily, we have to find the focal length. So focal length of lens, we know the formula. F is equal to 1 upon P. Why I written like this? Because we know the lens, power lens formula, that is the P is equal to 1 upon F. Getting it? 1 upon F, just I rearrange the formula and then we can get our answer. So 1 upon 1.5. Now those students don't know the multiplication division, please at once read the tables, learn the tables, you can solve it easily. And by division, we will get this answer, that is a plus 0.67 meter. Why? Because focal length is measured in the meter, remember this. Focal length is measured in meter. Now here, so focal length is positive. We have seen that about the sign convention. When focal length is the positive, means what happened here? What you will get here? Focal length is positive. Means this is a convex lens, we have to use convex lens, and that person having the defect of vision, that is a farsightedness or hypermetropia. Farsightedness or hypermetropia. When there is a positive, that time it is there. Where we will get the image? Which will get here, right hand side. Or we can say here first quadrant, just we are speaking about the sign convention. So we have to get here focal length positive. So we have to use your convex lens, and that vision is there. Which vision? That defect of vision is hypermetropia or farsightedness. Understood, everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so next problem I am taking here. So 5 centimeter high object is placed at a distance of 25 centimeter from a converging lens. What is here? 5 cm high object is placed at a distance of 25 cm from converging lens of focal length of 10 cm. Then determine the position, size and type of the object. Here you are getting all answers, but how that we have to solve? Once again, I am reading the same problem. The 5 cm object, high object is placed at a distance of 25 cm from the converging lens. Converging lens means which lens here is used? Can you tell me which lens is used?
Concave lens.
Concave or convex for converging?
Convex.
Convex lens is used here. Okay. And its object is placed at high 5 cm. Suppose we are able to take like this in science convention. So this object is kept high, means here we are getting this object upside. But first quadrant or second, third, fourth quadrant that we will see there. Okay. So distances of that are 25 cm from converging lens of a focal length of 10 cm. Determine the position, size and type of the object. So here you are getting there height of the object. What you are getting here? Height of the object. Okay. So we are going to write height of the object means HO is equal to 5 cm. Height of the object is we are getting here 5 cm. Then object distance is there negative. What is it? Object distance is negative. Will you tell me why it's negative? Anybody can tell me? Your converging lens is there. So for your kind of information, when we are using the converging lens or convex lens, that time that object is kept left hand side. Left side of the your center of curvature or center of your lens. Okay. So due to that, your minus 25 cm and converging lens due to that will get the focal length that is a 10 cm, it's a positive. Okay, getting it? Now, by lens formula, which formula we have to use here? By lens formula, that is 1 upon F is equal to 1 upon V minus 1 upon U, we are writing. And here, this is your lens formula, 1 upon F is equal to 1 upon V minus 1 upon U. V means you know that distance of the object and U means, sorry, V means the distance of image and U means distance of object. Okay. And here for the focal length. So just we are going to rearrange this formula because we have to find the distance of image. Okay. So 1 upon V is equal to, what do we get? 1 upon V is equal to 1 upon. Can you tell me what will you get?
1 upon F minus 1 upon U.
1 upon F minus 1 upon F. But what we are going to do is 1 minus 1 upon U, we are going to connoting this side. So we are getting here a plus sign, not negative sign. Okay. So just I am writing here 1 upon F upon 1 upon U. Okay. Getting it? Why I done it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes.
It's a very simple, it's mathematical part is there. And now we have to write the values of given this. We don't know the this value means the distance of image. So we are going to write first, that is the focal length. What is it? 1 upon minus 25 cm, correct? 1 upon minus 25 cm. And then we are, sorry, 1 upon U, we are writing that is minus 25 cm. And focal length is given. Plus 10, so I have written here 1 upon minus 25 plus 1 upon 10. While we have to add this number, then we should there require the same base, correct? So here 25 and here 10. If we multiply by this 5, here we'll get a 50. And when we are going to multiply by 2, then here we'll get a 50. But now here we are going to write this minus 125, 1 upon 50. Suppose you are writing, or directly we can write the answer. Because you can understand it easily. So what will you get here? 25 to the 50 and here 50. So 5 minus 2. What will you get here? 5 minus 2. So what will you get here? Plus 3. What will you get? Plus 3. And then this below will get the plus 50. 3 upon. So must take a second. I'm going to get the answer. I'm going to get the answer. डाइव सिमुलेट
मला
वाटतं
अंडरस्टँडिंग सर
ओके गेटिंग इट नो एकदम सिंपल आहे समजत नसेल तर विचारून घ्या ओके तर काय आलं आपल्या इथं 1/3/50 1 अपॉन व्ही इज इक्वल टू व्हॉट वी हॅव गॉट हियर 3/50 ओके 1/V इज इक्वल टू 3/50 देन वी हॅव टू राईट द फायनल आन्सर दॅट इज अ V, we have write value of V, so what will you get? 50/3. What will you get? 50/3 means what? You can write 50 on the 50 and V into 3, correct? Then 3V you will get. So when we have to find the value, then this 3N for multiplication, it will go for your division, and then we'll get it 16.7 centimeters. So here object, image distance is the positive. Image distance is positive, so due to it form on the right hand side. It form on the right hand side. Those students want to take a screenshot, you can take. Okay, I'm going to take. Means I'm going to rub this, and remaining part I'm going to take here. Okay. 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 Now we have got there 16.7. Now we should know the size of the object, how much it will be there, and for size of the object we have seen the magnification. That is a V upon U is equal to what is your height of the image upon height of the object. Okay, so now here if you put their value, that already which value we got there 16.7, and use value, you know that it was there -25 and H object's value there 5. So we write like this. HI, we are going to just rearrange this formula. Okay, HI is equal to, so what will we get? 50. Instead of writing directly that 16.7, we are writing directly 50 upon 3 into here -25 and then multiplied by 5 is your H naught, and then you will get the value here. Very simple. What is that? Will tell me what will get the value here. If you do this multiplication, what will get the value? So -2.1 here 2 will get, then 52 so sorry here 25 is there, no sorry 25 1 that 25 25 to the 50 here, and then remain here. Then 2 by 10, 10 upon -3, because your -10 is remains. So if you divide this, you will get -3.3. What will you get here? 3. Minus sign should be there. Okay, 3.3. So here I am writing that -3.3 centimeter. This is your this height of the image. This will be their height of the image. And then if this is getting the their negative sign, that means it is their formed real and inverted, and it is a real inverted and diminished because it is on negative side. Okay, getting it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So last one question we are going to see here. Just I know that already 3 minutes over, but we'll take it. Very simple problem. Third one. Third and fourth, two problem on women. No? So three lenses having the power 2, 2.5 and 1.7, they are kept touching in a row. What is the total power of the lens combination? So here given directly power, this P value is given there 2, 2.5 and 1.7. So we know the power formula, that is P is equal to 1/F. P is equal to 1/F, but here directly given so power, so we can directly add that P1, first you have to give the name P1. That is a 1, 2, then P2, that is a 2.5, and then next one P3, that is given there. What is given P3 there? 1.7D. So right directly like this 2, 2.5. Here you need to remember that is a diopter. Okay, 2 plus 2.5 plus 1.7. and we'll get your addition. That is the 6.6 diopter. This is your answer of third one question. Got it, everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay, now last one I'm going to take here. See there, what is the fourth number question? If you read it carefully, so you'll get there. An object kept 60 centimeter from a lens gives a virtual image. Object is kept at a distance is there 60 centimeter and it gives a virtual image 20 centimeter in the front of lens. What is the focal length of lens? Is it converging lens or diverging lens? Okay, so what is given? The object distance is given. So here we can take object distance. That is a u, means here minus 60 centimeter. What's your minus 60 centimeter? Which reason is given in the your question? When the object is kept 60 centimeter from a lens, use a virtual image. When we are getting the virtual image, that time that object is at the left hand side of the our eye lens, or you can suggest which lens you are using there. Then image distance, we are getting image distance also there, virtual image, and it's here minus 20, means here you are getting its b is equal to minus 20 centimeter. Okay, then using the lens formula, 1 upon b minus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f. So this is your u and this is your v. So you can write 1 upon minus 20. We have to find the focal length. So minus 20 minus 1 upon 60. Yeah, minus 60, then you will get here. What is the answer? 1 upon f. So very simple. Now 20 is here. We have to make their equal basis first or denominators. Then 20 multiplied by 3. So we'll get here 3 minus 1 upon 60. Getting it? 3 minus 1 upon 60. And then we'll get here 2 upon minus 60. We know that table, that is both are present in 2's table only, and we'll get the answer 1 upon minus 30 centimeter. Minus 30 centimeter. And when we are going to speak about just focal length, it will get, so 1 upon f instead of 1 upon f, so we'll get directly its value, f is equal to minus 30 centimeter. Got it, student? And here, when we are getting the focal length negative, that time this is the diverging lens, means concave lens. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we'll wind up here. Thank you, students.